All right, guys, out here today at the camp. Guys, out here at camp today, and today I want to try something a little bit new. Put together my first smoker for the bush camp.
There it is, looking pretty good.
So basically all I did was I took that cooking tripod I had here at the camp, and I put a couple more sticks on it to give the frame of the structure a little bit more strength, and then I went around and just found dead trees with dead bark, ripped big sheets of bark off, and put it around it.
And as you can see, it is working nice.
There it is. So basically, I'll give you a tour around it. It's basically just a teepee. It's a cooking tripod covered up with bark. It is pretty good. It lets just enough airflow in it to keep it going. It's not 100% airtight, but it's pretty good. Smoke's coming out here out of the top, and I think it's working pretty good. Every once in a while it sparks back up and catches fire, but as long as I keep the smoke mostly smoky and not a whole lot of flame, I should be able to smoke these pieces of meat pretty good. I've also got some potatoes, some Brussels sprouts, some mixed vegetables that I'm gonna cook up here. And what I'm trying to do is figure out another way to cook. I want to be able to cook outside of the fire ring, so like transfer my coals into something, and then I can cook that way. I'm not right on the fire when I'm trying to cook, so I'm trying to figure something out, some way to move coals or a secondary cooking area so that I can cook in multiple places, or so I could cook while I have a fire going. So I'm gonna walk around and try to brainstorm and figure something out. All right, so hear me out. First thing I wanted to try was taking a nice, real dense, unseasoned piece of wood and split it in half and then kind of hollow it out. Basically create like a, you know, so once it's, not doing very good explaining this, split it in half, and then each half could be used as almost like a bowl where I could do a burn bowl and burn out a little area for coals to sit in. And that way I could just sit my frying pan on top of those coals and I have like a portable kitchen. Eventually it would burn all the way through, but I thought it'd be worth trying. But I'm looking at this and it's already split, so I don't know if it's gonna work or not. Let's give it a go. I kinda wanna, I don't know, split like here. This probably isn't very good on my axe either. It's really not made for this. That's not a heavy enough piece of wood. Okay, that actually worked pretty well. I didn't split it all the way in half. I just made a flat surface on it. It took about a quarter of it off. Whatever tree this is, I think it's an ash. It's the same tree that I'm taking the bark off of. Not the exact same tree, but the same type of tree, because I can just tell by how the bark looks. It looks same. Alright, so you guys can see the premise. I want an area separate from the campfire where I can cook food like this. To me, this looks more like how to set the scrambled oak base camp on fire, because I got this set up in my fire, dry firewood area. Not gonna be the permanent solution, but this is just kind of how I wanted to cook my potatoes and stuff today. You guys kind of see what I'm trying to do, is create an area where I can transfer coals to, then I can use them for cooking. It's really easy to cook when you've got coals away from your fire. You could see how I was blowing on those coals. I'm getting within like 3 inches of them. You can't do that with a fire. There's so many other coals and such a big flame that it'll burn you. So this is a cool way to be able to pull some coals away from the fire, cook secondary, a little secondary spot to cook. You can see it's starting to hollow out this piece of wood pretty good. And it's providing heat to the underside of my frying pan, which has got potatoes in there.
Look at them potatoes, boy.
Yeah, cooking up some vegetables over here, and then the meat's being smoked inside there.
Look at the veggies, boy. Look at the greens.
So yeah, this thing's working pretty well. Just set it up here, just like that. Gives you a nice little secondary place to cook up some veggies. All right, this jerky's been cooking for a couple hours, so I think it's about time to take it out and at least test it, see what it looks like, see what it tastes like.
Look at that jerky, boy. Look at that jerky, boy.
perfect.
Amazing.
Just get the rust off the fire. And get the veggies out too.
Look at it.
Everything looks soft. I think it's done.
Take a little salt, a little pepper.
Alright boys, time to chow on down. It's been a long time coming. Here it is. My veggies. Potatoes, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and onions.
Oh, this smells so good. It smells so good.
Cooked in butter and water. Let's give one of these big fat Brussels sprouts a try.
Oh, that's good.
All right, let's take another look at this jerky. So I put together a little bit of a smoker out here at base camp. So this meat I got at the store, marinated overnight, dried out here at the camp.
Oh man, that's good.
So what that did was it gave me kind of an idea as to what size pieces would I want to process wild game into. Pretty much the same as dehydrating indoors with an oven or with a dehydrator. You want to cut it thinner the quicker it cooks. It also gave me a little bit of an idea as to how long it takes. Long time. Just been out here smoking for 3 hours probably. So probably not the best way to cook food, but if you go out, you're in the bush for a month, you might catch a lot of fish one day. You might want to dry it so you can save it to have some food for the next day if you don't catch any fish. So it's a good thing to learn. Broccoli. Man, that's good. Secret ingredient was butter. You put some butter on them, you put some salt and pepper on them. Man, are they good. I could eat those every day. So, earlier today, as soon as I got out to camp, I did a live stream, YouTube live stream. Something I'm gonna do some more often. It was pretty fun. Really good. Alright, here's my little, I don't know what you're gonna call it, my burn bowl.
getting lightheaded now.
So I don't really envision using this burn bowl as a bowl. I see it more as a way that I can cook, you know. Put a couple of coals in there from my fire and set it in that shelf right here. And cook. So yeah, that worked out really well today. Honestly, I'll probably build another shelf. That really is my firewood area, so I want to keep it that way. So I'll probably build something similar and put it off to the side somewhere as like a little secondary way to cook. All right, guys, I think that about does it for me today out here at the camp. Today I put together my first little bushcraft smoker. It worked out really well, actually. Cooked up a plate of veggies. Man. Smoking meat takes a long time. I was out here all day. Knocked out a live stream earlier. I said that, like I said earlier, I'm gonna be doing live streams once a week from now on. Probably from my house. But I will flip it on live when I'm out here shooting video sometime too. That seemed like a cool thing to do. Had a lot of people chatting, and actually had some people donate money. There's a feature where you can send money, which was amazing. I wasn't expecting that. Super cool. But yeah, this week, just this one video, guys. I'm gonna go to the camera store and buy a new tripod as mine has broken. But yeah, I'm eager to get back out here. You can see it's spring. You can see it's spring around here now. We got leaves budding. And I'm gonna take a look around this bit of property and see if I can't find a patch of ramps and morels, some wild edibles. So guys, I appreciate you guys watching. And until next time, Scrambled O signing off.